Pretty good sushi.
My friend Ben, who's the architect for a sushi restaurant, Bamboo Sushi, was asked if he knew anyone who could fix some cutting boards that they were having trouble with, as they use them a lot, and they're just starting to get a little worn out. Now, two of them had started to crack. They wondered if this could be fixed. Our thought was that we could cut out the damaged area and then re-glue the cutting board back together again. I brought the boards back to the shop. These are teak cutting boards, so they're very durable. And I set up the fence to be the width of where the crack is in the board. Now on one of them, the crack was going through the board sort of at an angle, so I had to actually cut out a little bit more width than the saw blade, and this worked. Now the cut with the table saw was actually really good, and I was thinking I would just glue them up from there, but I thought I would try joining the two edges, and this actually made the glue joint much nicer. I didn't think it was going to be that much better. I laid out marks for biscuits, and I used biscuits to hold the joint together. Like I've said before, it's not so much for strength, although it helps for that. It's more that the biscuits help align the two pieces when they go together, and they won't slide around in the clamps with the wet glue on the joint. So I put glue on. Now I did a little research on the manufacturer's website. This is Titebond 3 glue, and they say for teak, if you cut it and then glue it quickly so that the oil doesn't start to come out on your cut face, the glue should work for teak just fine. One of the parameters for this work was that the restaurant is open 7 days a week, so they couldn't be without their cutting boards for very long. One of the first ideas to solve this was to have me pick up the cutting boards at midnight and cut the boards in half and re-glue them together and fix the crack overnight and have them glue in the early morning and then finish them up later in the morning and get them back to the restaurant by noon the next day. But this seemed a little harsh. So what we ended up doing is having the restaurant buy some plastic cutting boards to use for a day while I worked on the wooden cutting boards. So I had to get this done in a day. And I wanted the glue to actually squeeze out a little bit all along the seam so that I wouldn't have any void on the surface where the joint is. But I also didn't want any glue on the surface as it's a cutting board. So I clamped them to where the glue squeezed out and then I wiped the glue off. I glued those up, and they look good. I let them dry overnight. Now, the other thing that they wanted me to do to these boards was to sand the surface a little bit, just to sort of take the edge off of all of the knife cuts that are in the board. So I didn't really sand down to a new surface. I just kind of took off the edge. Now, these boards being used for fish every night and being re-oiled every day are completely impregnated with oil, so they clogged up the sanding discs really quickly. I think at some point these will have to just be planed down, but that's not what we did at this point. So I spent a lot of time cleaning sandpaper. After I was done with my work, the restaurant cleaned and then re-oiled the cutting boards, so they were ready to be used in the restaurant. Now, about 3 months after this, we went back to the restaurant to see how they were doing. After a little finagling with the hostess, we managed to get into the restaurant to take some photography. And Ben knows the head chef, so we got in. And they really like the cutting boards, and they seem to be holding up just fine. You can see they get a lot of use. Thanks for watching.